Go.
We at HAPO have initiated web series on construction technology and practices. We are trying to educate our end customers and civil engineers on the best practices of construction and the latest technology which is coming in. Today, we are talking about how to arrive at quantities of cement, sand, water for plaster application. The moment we want to do a plaster, three basic input data should be available with us. The three data are how much thick is the plaster, what area we are trying to cover, and what mix proportion are we choosing. Here we have considered a thickness of 12 mm, area to be covered is 10 square meter, and the mix proportion is 1 is to 4. When I say 1 is to 4 proportion, I want to say that for every one part of cement, we need to add 4 part of sand. And this proportion has to be in volume, not in weight. These things are to be always remembered. These are by volume, not by weight. Here today we are trying to put more emphasis on DLBD method. DLBD method basically take into account the properties of local available sand which is available at Nagpur, Delhi, Mumbai, elsewhere, everywhere. So the cement DLBD, basically a factory made product, will more or less remain 1400 kg per cubic meter. Fine aggregate, in our present case, we have taken 1600 kg per cubic meter. If you talk about Pune market, the range of DLBD would be in the range of 1550 to 1650. And the water is generic, it will remain 1000 kg per cubic meter. Calculation part, we'll try to find cement, we'll convert cement in weight to volume, taking into consider the DLBD of cement as 1400. So for 1400 of cement, the volume occupied is 1 cubic meter. As cement comes in a bag of 50 kg, the arrived value is 0.036 cubic meter. Volume of one bag of cement will have a volume of one bag of cement will be 0.036 cubic meter. Second part would be to find the volume of sand. As our proportion is 1 is to 4, the volume of sand will be 4 times the volume of cement, which here we have arrived is 0.144. Okay, this 0.144 cubic meter will convert into kg. While converting into kg, we have considered the DLBD and finally arrived at weight of sand, that is 230. Now we have got two figures, that is 50, for every 50 kg of cement, the weight of sand required is 230. Quantity of water required. As we are done with the quantity of cement and sand, what we require to make a plaster workable is water. To have a thumb rule, take 20% by weight of dry material, that is cement plus sand, the water content. Initial water content would be 20% of the arrived cement and sand content. Water quantity can be adjusted to get required workability, which may vary typically from 17 to 25. Coming on the calculation part, weight of water required would be total dry weight material into 20%. In this particular case, we are getting a value of 46 kg. One more thing to be kept in mind is density of cement mortar. Density of cement mortar is 2200 kg per cubic meter. It means 2200 kg of cement mortar will occupy 1 cubic meter volume. Total weight of wet plaster which we have arrived is 336. Volume of cement mortar for one batch of 1 is to 4 is arrived is 0.13 cubic meter. We are trying to find the quantity of 12 mm thick plaster for an area of 10 square meter. So volume of plaster for covering that amount of plaster would be 0.12 cubic meter. Coming on the calculation part, we try to arrive the quantities of different material for 0.12 cubic meter of plaster. Here are the calculation given. We are basically converting 0.153, which is the one batch unit, to what is required is 0.12. The final figures are cement required would be 39 kgs, sand required would be 180, water required would be 44. If we are trying to get a 12 mm thick cluster occupying an area of 10 square meter with a proportion of 1:4. Here we have tried to tabulate cement proportions of different cement proportion with cement and sand quantity individually given.